And then we have this spanning tree to not have from Legend in order to solve the diameter constraint, and we will see that. So, on the capacitor facility location, we have a set of candidate facilities, F, we have a set of clients, C, we have fixed cost of opening a facility, so if we open or not, facility is a cost, a fixed cost F, and we have a demand cost associated to the clients and the facilities, we call here C. So the main objective to this problem is to open facilities to serve all clients with a minimum cost. And an example, simple example to understand the visual of the solution. So suppose we have four facilities and three clients. Here we serve all three clients with only two facilities. We choose to open only two facilities of the four facilities candidates. So this is a solution, an example of solution of uncapacitated facility location. But now let's understand how we can see hot constraint, the second problem I present to you, as an uncapacitated facility location. We can reformulate the hot constraint as an uncapacitated facility location. So to do that, we said that any selected facility is also a client that can serve itself with a zero cost. And we said that the fixed cost of opening a facility is exactly the cost between the route and the neighbors. So let's understand better with a figure. In this first figure, we have an optimal solution to uncapacitated facility location. Suppose we open two facilities, and as all facilities is also a client, they serve themselves with a zero cost, okay? Because we have to serve all clients and even uncapacitated facility location. And we can see this solution to uncapacitated facility location as a solution to hot constraint when we have H equals 2. If we plug the root vertex that we set the predetermined before with the facilities we chose, and the cost of attaining these facilities with the R vertex is exactly the cost of opening a facility. So that's the relation between these two solutions that we will explore here. So let's understand the idea, these three problems, the relation between them to get the idea well. So as we see, we have the first problem, the solution to the first problem, the diameter constraint with D equals 4, with diameter equals 4, is a root and 3. We saw that. And each root R from the hot constraint, the second problem, implies a subproblem we call here SR. So for each vertex we choose to be a root, we have a subproblem, a different subproblem to solve. And each subproblem SR, in that case, will be reformulated as an uncapacitated facility location, as we saw in the previous presentation. So the idea is, we have, in order to solve diameter constraint, the first one, we have to solve cardinality to the uncapacitated facility location, where each facility is child of a predetermined root we solve. And in order to solve cardinality to the uncapacitated facility location, we are solving a cardinality to the hot constraint with H equals 2, where each root is a vertex of G, each root implies a C problem, we know that. And by solving all subproblems with root R, we can get the subproblem that has the minimum cost. The subproblem that has the minimum cost is exactly the solution of diameter constraint with D equals 4. That's the idea to explore here. So now I will show to you how we managed to solve, to understand this cardinality to be uncapacitated facility location with a preprocessing method we do before solving the cardinality fields of problems. Let's see. So the algorithm flow that we do is for each subproblem with R, we calculate primal bounds with the heuristics and local search to uncapacitated facility location. And next we calculate dual bounds with Lagrangian relaxation. We will see more details in next presentations. With that information, with primal bounds and dual bounds, we do reduction tests that we see later with more details. And next, we can check if this problem is feasible to be the optimal solution. and we run this loop as long as n equals to c satisfied. So let's see the Lagrangian relaxation in order to get dual bounds. Here is a classical model to uncapacitated facilitation. We have x variables indicating if a client should be assigned to a facility or not. We have y variables indicating if a facility should be open or not. We have the cost associated, we solve that. And we have the set of constraints that we have to serve all clients, that the set of constraints true here. And the relation between the variables and the set of constraints 3. So we associate non-negative multipliers lambda to the set of constraints 2 to each client. And we have this quadratic problem, very classical one. And it's a quadratic problem very easy to solve. We can solve with an inspection. And we can see that the Lagrangian cost for facility, we call PSC, to be the cost of opening a facility. Remember, we said that the cost of opening a facility is exactly the cost between the root and the neighbors in order to get the reformulation of the proposal. So the cost for a facility is the cost of opening a facility, CRB, CRI, and the cost associated to all the clients that is good for this facility to attend. And good for us is the cost of a client here to be negative, because we have a minimization problem, okay? So let's see the reduction test. Very. So we have X and Y bar to be the optimal solution to our Lagrangian soup problem. Because suppose we solve the Lagrangian soup problem and in the current iteration, and we have this optimal solution X and Y bar with the value Z, okay? And we have X and Y R to be the optimal solution to the sub problem we are solving. So we are in the current sub problem with the root R. And suppose we have a bar Z to be the best upper bounding hand for diameter of a string. The best upper bounding hand here is the lowest upper bound we get from all sub problems that we are solving. So suppose in a Lagrangian soup problem we have a facility to be closed. Okay, suppose. So y variables is equal 4. So what can we do? What can we test? We can test it, get the value of the Lagrangian soup problem, z, the dual value, and we add the cost of opening this facility that is closed in Lagrangian soup problem. We can try to open by adding this cost. If the dual variable plus the cost of open a facility exceed the best upper bound we know, we know for sure that this facility should not be open in the sub problem with the root R. So if we can set the Y variables, the facility with a Y variables in the sub problem with the root R is zero. And we can do this with a lot of other, we do a lot of other reduction tests with the same idea. We check if an open facility can be closed as well. We check if a client would be assigned if a facility is open or not in Lagrangian soup problem as well. We calculate upper and lower bounds on the number of facilities that could be open in a solution. So we calculate lower bounds and upper bounds in the number of facilities can be open in the solution. And we calculate upper and lower bounds of the number of clients as well assigned to a facility. So let's see the results. This is a table, a result summary of the instance, the classical instance of the term for diameter constraint, the problem that we want to solve. The term to solve this facility up to 161 nodes. And as you can see, we managed to eliminate most of all sub problems. We get only the sub problem that matters to solve on the capacitated facilitation. And we fixed a lot of variables as well in the algorithm flow I showed to you. And we managed to solve up to optimality all these instances in literature with time very, 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 very competitive. instance remains. We saw this mounting amount of reduced uncapacitated facilitation with new value inequalities. So what the value inequalities we have? So remember that we calculate the upper and lower bounds of the number of facilities. So we can have this constraint that the number of facilities should be between these bounds, and the number of the clients should be between these bounds be calculated in a reduction test. So doing that, we solved the first instance with additional 3 seconds, very quick, and we solved the second instance with additional 5 seconds. And the configuration of the computer is shown here. Okay. Some remarks to conclude. We could solve much larger instances than the existing one in the literature, which is very nice. And we solved 14 of 16 optimality certificates by using the pre-processing method only. And is it possible to extend this approach to for diameter up to 5? So we can extend this by setting that each edge is a subproblem. Now, in that case, each edge would be a subproblem, and we can try to do that. But we have a higher computational time because we trade n vertices to n square subproblems. So that's it. Thanks for listening.